Hello, students. Mr. Madison here with another video lesson for you. The objective of this lesson is to review with you a very important skill. This is a skill that we covered earlier in the year, but even then, when we did cover it, it was a skill that you had had already learned before, probably as early as seventh grade. But certainly it was a major, major topic in Algebra 1. And what I'm referring to is finding the slope of a line and writing the equation for a line. And usually when I get to this point in the school year, I will review with students skills that they are going to apply almost every day when they get to Algebra 2. So writing the equation for a line and finding the slope and being able to deal with slope and analyze slope is a critical skill. Those are critical skills to have as you get to Algebra 2. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do a review of those skills. So our objective is just very simply to review slope and writing the equation for a line, writing linear equations. And when we're done here, the intent is that you'll be able to find the slope of a line, and you'll be able to write the equation for a line. So that's the goal. A reminder that you learned early on that slope is really referring to the rate of change. If you were a little bug traveling up this line, you would be changing your position as you move up the line, and you would be changing your position in two ways. So if you're going to go from, say, point A to point B, you would be moving further to the right at the same time you were getting higher. So you'd be moving horizontally and vertically at the same time. The ratio between your change, your vertical change, and your horizontal change is what we call the slope. So the vertical change, when you go from point A to point B, would be represented by this vertical line that we refer to as the rise. And the horizontal change, as you move from point A to point B, would be represented by this horizontal line that we call the run. Run corresponds to horizontal, rise corresponds to vertical. And then your slope is the ratio between those two values, and you just simply know it as slope equals rise over run. Now, if I assign coordinates to those two points, let's suppose this point up here is, say, 12, 8, and this point here is the point 4, 1, and I want to find the slope. What I need to do is figure out what the rise is and what the run is. Always remember that to find the rise, subtract the y's. So to find my top number here, the rise, I'm going to subtract my two y coordinates. So that would be 8 minus 1. And always remember that to find the run, the x's get it done. So what we're going to do to find the run here is subtract the two x coordinates. So I'm going to say 12 minus 4. So I'd have 7 over 8. So the slope of this line, and this is our variable that we use for slope, is at m, is 7 over 8. Just some general things about the slope. Anytime that you have a line that's positioned in this way, and what I mean by positioned in this way, I'm referring to the fact that it's leaning to the right. So as you go to the right, you're going uphill. This type of a line will always have a positive slope. Whereas this line that's leaning to the left will always have a negative slope. Now, if you have a line that's perfectly horizontal, it's a horizontal line, what you need to understand is if you move from this point to this point along that line, there's no rise. You don't go up and you don't go down. So if rise has a value of 0, that would give you a 0 in the numerator of that ratio, which gives you 0. So for a horizontal line, the slope is always equal to 0. Now, a vertical line is a different story. For a vertical line, if you went from this point to this point along the line, how would your position be changing? Well, you would be getting higher, you would move up, but you would not be moving to the left or the right. So in other words, there's no run. There's no run, which mathematically creates an issue, because if the run is equal to 0, that would give you a 0 in the denominator, which you cannot have. You cannot divide by 0. So what we say then is that for a vertical line, the slope is undefined. Now, if you kind of take these examples and combine them into one, you can make like a little house. And what you need to remember is that this side of the roof has a positive slope. This side of the roof has a negative slope. The horizontal floor would have a slope equal to 0, and the two vertical walls would have an undefined slope. Just nothing more than a way to remember that. Do one more example for you. Let's say this is the point negative 2, 13. And this is the point 7, negative 4. And your job is to find the slope. So here we go. Rise over run. To find the rise, subtract the y's. To find the run, the x's, get it done. The only thing you really have to be careful here of are the evil double negatives. So when I subtract the y's, I'm going to have 13 minus negative 4, which becomes 13 plus 4, double negative here becoming a plus. And then I'm going to have in the denominator, I'm going to subtract my two x's, I'd have negative 2 minus 7. So the slope then is going to equal, on the top I'm getting 17, on the bottom I'm going to get negative 9, and that would be my answer here for my slope. Okay, there's some concepts involving slope that really came into play as we studied some of our geometric figures, and these are the two concepts that I just like to review with you very quickly here. Consider these two lines. These two lines are parallel. And I just want to remind you that if the lines are parallel, then what's going to happen is you're going to have equal slopes. So this line right here might be the line y equals 2/3 x plus 10. This line right here would then have to be the line something like y equals 2/3 x plus 4. The slopes would have to be the same for these lines because they're parallel. If you have a parallelogram, you know that in a parallelogram, the opposite sides are parallel. So whatever the slope is for this line here, it would have to be the same as for this line here because those lines are parallel. So parallel lines have equal slopes. Now, if you have lines like this, that are perpendicular, then that means that the slopes have to be opposite reciprocals. The slopes are opposite reciprocals. So let's suppose that the slope for this line right here is something like 9/11. Then the slope of this line over here would have to be -11/9. So parallel lines have equal slopes. Perpendicular lines have slopes that are opposite reciprocals. Let's suppose you have a rectangle. One of the things we learned about rectangles is that every corner is a 90-degree angle. But whatever the slope is for this side, and whatever the slope is for this side, they're going to have to be opposite reciprocals. So if the slope of this side of the rectangle is, say, -9/7, then the slope of this side is going to have to be +7/9. Okay, so just very quickly, slope is rise over run. To find a rise, you subtract the y's. To find the run, the x's get it done. Be careful when you're doing that because sometimes evil double negatives will come into play. Any line that's positioned this way, leaning to the right, would have a positive slope. Any line leaning to the left would have a negative slope. Horizontal lines have slopes of zero, and vertical lines have slopes that are undefined. If you have parallel lines, their slopes have to be equal. And if you have perpendicular lines, their slopes have to be opposite reciprocals. All review stuff. The next part of this is to review with you how to write a linear equation. This is what a linear equation looks like. This is what we call the slope-intercept form. And the reason we call it the slope-intercept form is because this value right here in front of the x is going to be your slope. And this value right here is going to be your y intercept. And just to review with you very quickly what that means, here's your line here, and this point right here is B. That's the y intercept. So whatever number's right there, that corresponds to the y coordinate of that point right there. If you have a horizontal line, the equation for the horizontal line doesn't quite look like that. The equation for the horizontal line always looks like this. Y equals, and then you merely have a number, some number. Here's some examples. This would be the line with the equation y equals 2. This would be the line with the equation y equals 1. This would be the line with the equation y equals negative 4. So the equation for a horizontal line always has this shape to it right here. And it's always just y equals and then some number. If you have a vertical line, the equation always looks like this. X equals some number. And this equation, x equals some number, and this equation, y equals some number, I think you'll agree, they don't quite look like this. So the equations for all your other lines, other than horizontal and vertical, are going to look like this, y equals mx plus b. So let me give you some examples here very quickly of verticals. This line right here would be the line with the equation x equals 2. This line right here would be the line with the equation x equals 5. This line right here would be the vertical line with the equation x equals negative 3. So let's suppose you have this line right here. This will be like the simplest example I could come up with here. I tell you that the slope of this line right here is 2/3. And I tell you that this point right here is 2. And then I say to you, write the equation. Well, here's what the equation looks like. Y equals mx plus b. And I can always write the equation for a line if I have my value for b and I have my value for m. And those two values are given here. So the equation for this line is simply going to be y equals 2/3 x plus and I'm done. Now, other types of situations where you're asked to write the equation for a line, my recommendation is you start by doing this. This would be your starting point. For writing the equation for a line. So this right here is how I recommend you start every problem where you're asked to write the equation for a line. This is your starting point here. I'll write that down here, starting point. All right. Now, once you write that down, what you're going to do is you're going to plug a number in for x sub 1. You're going to plug a number in for y sub 1. And you're going to plug a number in for m. So you're just going to substitute those three values. After you substitute three values into this equation for x sub 1, y sub 1, and m, you're going to do maybe two algebra steps and you'll be done. So let me do an example here for you. Let's suppose that I tell you that the slope of a line is 1/2. And that on that line is the point 12, 4. And I'm asked to write the equation for the line. So I'm going to say y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1. I'm going to plug 12 in for x sub 1. I'm going to plug 4 in for y sub 1. And I'm going to plug 1/2 in for m. So I'm going to have y minus 4 equals 1/2 times the quantity x minus 12. All right, now here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to distribute this half. So that gives me y minus 4 equals 1 half x minus 6. Then I'm going to take this and add 4 to both sides of this equation. So when I add 4 to both sides, I'm going to get y over here equals 1 half x. And when I add 4 to negative 6, I'm going to get negative 2, and I'm done. There's my answer. Another example for you. Let's suppose you know that the slope of the line is negative 2/3, and that the line contains the point 9, negative 5. And you're asked to write the equation. So, starting point, y minus y sub 1 equals m times the quantity x minus x sub 1. This is going to be x sub 1. This negative 5 is going to be y sub 1. And negative 2/3 I'm going to plug in for m. So here we go. I'm going to have y minus negative 5. I'm hopeful that you understand why I'm going to make this plus 5. Because it's a minus negative gives me a plus 5. Equals negative 2/3 times the quantity x minus 9. Two steps away from being done. I'm going to distribute this guy here. And when I do that, I'm going to get negative 2/3 x. And then this negative times that negative makes this a positive. And then that'll be 6. Then I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides. When I subtract 5 from both sides, I'd have y equals negative 2/3 x plus 1, and I'm home. One more example, and we'll be done. Let's suppose you know that the slope of the line is, say, negative 4, and that the line contains the point negative 1, 11. All right. So I want to write the equation for the line that has a slope of negative 4 and contains the point negative 1, 11. Here's how I start. I always write down y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1. Then I substitute 3 values. I'm going to put negative 1 in for x sub 1. I'm going to put 11 in for y sub 1. And I'm going to put negative 4 in for m. So here I go. Y minus 11 equals m, negative 4 times x minus negative 1. So this minus negative 1 becomes x plus 1. I'm going to distribute the negative 4. So I'd have y minus 11 equals negative 4x minus 4. Then to finish, I'm going to add 11 to both sides. And I'm going to have y equals negative 4x plus 7, and I'm home. All right. So we had this as our objective. We wanted to review slope, which we did here. And then we wanted to review writing linear equations, which we did here. Remember that if you have a horizontal line, your equation will always be y equals some number. And these are 3 examples right here. Y equals 2, y equals 1, y equals negative 4. If you have a vertical line, your equation will always be x equals some number. And these are examples here. X equals negative 3, x equals 2, x equals 5. Otherwise, any other line that has some slope to it other than 0 or an undefined slope is going to have an equation that looks like this right here. To write the equation, I would use this as my starting point. Right here. I think this is very, very useful, very, very helpful, very, very to the point. I think that this is a really good technique to have in place in order to write the equation for a line. And this is how I would start. And then we did some examples here. And all you're going to do is you're going to substitute values for x sub 1, y sub 1, and m. Do 2 algebra steps and you'll have your answer. And you can look, all these answers are in the form y equals mx plus b. Y equals mx plus b, y equals mx plus b. So there you have it. I hope this review was helpful. There'll be some problems for you to do. And if you're if you're unsure of how to write the equation for a line, or you're unsure of how to find the slope, then maybe you should rewatch this video. So folks, I'm hopeful that this video was helpful. Thank you for your attention. Make sure that you get your problems done.